Welcome back guys. So in this video I am going to talk about comparator features, which it came as a part of Java 8, as well as how we can write the comparator by using Java 8 functional programming, right? So if you remember earlier when we had a data of type custom object in the list, right, we used to write comparator, and comparator will allow us to do the sorting based on the multiple fields, right? So first we will see that what was the old way when we used to write logic in the comparator and how easy it is with the Java 8. So first, if you try to remember, so before starting with comparator, let me tell you the structure of the class. This is our example class, okay? And here I have created one array list which will take the data of person object. And here in the same Java file, as we know that we can create multiple default class. So you have one person class, and person has some fields: first name, age, last name, employee and weight. So again, the person has a reference of employee. So a person has employee object, you can see that. Person has the employee object, which means in the same file there is a class called employee class also. So employee class has salary and designation. This is private in the nature, so we have created getter and setter for that. And then this employee class has one parameterized constructor, and then I'm overriding the two string. So this is all core Java concept. That is the reason I already wrote the code. So whatever the intent of this class is to learn Java 8 feature, right? So this, I assume that you are familiar with this. If not, please watch my core Java series. Again, same thing here. If you look at these all fields, I have created one constructor, parameterized, then getter and setter, right? So this is nothing but there are three class here. One is the public class, two is the default class, the person class and employee class. Now I have to write some sorting. So in this list we can see that we have a data of type person. In the list we are adding the person object, and if you look at the entire object, basically this is the entire object, the person object, you have name, then what you have is if you look at our person object, what we have in the constructor, we have first name, last name, age, weight, and then we have an employee, right? We have an employee, and then we are mapping with this keyword. So basically this will differentiate between your class variable and local variable. So that is the reason when I'm creating the object, if you look at here, I have a first name, last name, then what I have age, weight and employee. So I have an age, I have a weight. Then what is the employee? Employee is the other object, right? Employee is the other object which will give us the employee object. So I'm creating one more employee object, and employee object internally takes what? It takes salary and designation. Clear? Right? Because this employee is the reference type. This is the reference type. This is not an instance variable. It's a reference variable of custom object, right? So till here we are clear. Now first write the old way of implementation. So how old way we used to do? In the old way, if I have to write, let's say, comparator, what I will do, I will write here comparator, and this what I want to compare of type person object, then I will write comparator is equal to new, I will write anonymous inner class, right? And then here I will override the compare method. I can write here return o1 dot, let's say, get first name, we have getter and setter, dot compare to o2 dot get first name, right? Why this guy is crying? Any reason for that? So the one reason why, what I can see, that I need to supply the type of object, right, in anonymous inner class. So you can see that this is the old way of writing, right? In the old way, we used to create the object of anonymous inner class. Then what you do is you overwrite the compare method and then write the logic. This was the old way. So through this way, yes, we can do a sorting. So if I have to do the sorting, I can write here collections, which is available in the Java util package, collections dot sort. And then I can go for this one. So I can supply the list, which is nothing but my array list, and I can supply this comparator, right? I have to make this as a static because I don't want to create the object. And then the sorting will happen, and if you will print the list, you can see that your object will be sorted. So I am sorting based on the first name. So the first name, so the after sorting, this is going to be your first data, this is second data, and this is the third data after sorting, right? So let me run that and let me show you first. Yeah, so A came as first name. Then here, if you'll go to this second object, first name is BB. So basically, let me show you how it is. So this is your first object, till where? Till here. So this is the entire thing is your first object. You can see that your first object has first name, A is last name, then employee object. Employee object has internally salary and designation. And then this is, I mean, this entire thing is a one object, okay? Again, after person, that is the another object, right? Till wait, till here, wait 7.0. So this is the another object, right? It's a big object, right? So you are seeing that a big length, but this is, I did not do anything. This is all done by two string method. You guys can override the two string method and that will work fine. Right, let me show you again. So in the person, if you look at, I'm overriding the two string method, okay? And even in the employee class, I'm overriding the two string method. So this is taken care, right? We don't need to bother for that, and we know that already how to override two string method. So this is the old way. How can we do the same thing with Java 8 with the help of functional programming? Can I write this everything, this big code? Can I write this big code in one line? Let's try that, writing this big code in the one line. So take this and write here, let's say name comparator is equal to, so it takes two arguments, right? Copy this. It takes two arguments, arrow, and what we do, we compare get first name dot compare to O2 dot get first name. Can I write this big code in one line like this? You can see that your entire code came in one line. Let me put this line here so that we can see that. See, you can see that your entire code came in one line. It's a one liner code now. So whatever comparator you have written, you can replace with this, right? By now we are familiar with how to write a function, right? So the same comparator, when you convert into the lambda expressions, so basically this comparator takes two argument, okay? And after arrow, you are doing that the comparison, right? So basically, if you go to the comparator, press control, go to the comparator, and we will see that comparator is the functional interface, right? Why functional interface? Because it has only one abstract method. But when you do control O, you can see that there are a lot more method. It's not only compare, you have reversed, then comparing, like lot of overloaded method for then comparing, then reverse, then natural order, then null first, null last, then again you have comparing, right? This is then comparing and this is comparing, and then null first, null last. So these are all actually, these are default methods which came as a part of Java 1.8 in the comparator interface. So now, if you go for the other method, as what I was mentioning, see, these are all default method which came as a part of Java 1.8. In Java 1.8, we can write as many default methods as you want without breaking the existing implementation. So you can see that all are default method which came as a part of Java 1.8. I will cover each and every method one by one. Do not get panic. I will make sure that everything you will understand. Okay, just be with me. So if you go back now to the coding part, this we just replaced our old way of writing to the new way. This is the new way of doing the things. Okay, you can write the function like this and both will do the same job. So instead of doing this, if I will go and supply this name comparator, actually it will work in the same way. See, you can see that AA, then after person object C here, after person object again first name BB, then again after person object is CC. So it, sorting is happening, right? So now you got it how you can replace your anonymous class with this functional programming, right? So basically, if you'll correlate, if you'll try to understand this takes two argument, okay, and it compares that. Can I simplify this, right? Can I simplify this? Yes, I can simplify this because my lambda expressions are very smart. When in the comparator, when you are supplying the type of object as a person, then we don't need to in the parenthesis, we don't need to supply the type of input argument. We don't need to supply because your function will understand what is the type of input, because here the type is person. So this two input type is going to be person automatically, so we don't need to supply. So this is the simplest version. You can see that this is the simplest version of comparator and how simple it is, guys, right? Now can I see, if you look at here, we are writing a comparator separately, right? Can I write same thing inside the code? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. I can make this more simple. So in the same collection.sort, what I can do, whatever comparator you have written, I can copy from here and I can write it here itself. See how simple it is in Java 1.8. You can write the comparator here itself. Because what is the return type? What is the return type of this function? The return type is what? Comparator of person. And what this sort will take? See, sort has two methods. One will take list and one will take list with comparator, right? So basically, what is this? This is the first name comparator, right? So now you can understood with a Java 8 how simple code looks like. Your all 3, 5, 6 lines of code becomes a single liner, right? So this is the replacing old way to the new way. Now there are a lot more things came as a part of Java 1.8, and we have seen that lot of ready-made method here, right? When I press Control O, we have lot of ready-made default methods. How these default methods works, right? We will see that. So let's say I don't want to write all this. Okay, I don't want to write all this. I have a requirement where I need to sort by first name. Okay, I have a requirement where I need to sort by the first name. How do I write a logic? How do I write a comparator? I can write in very simple way. I don't need to write this much. I can go here and this is my name comparator 2. What I will do, I will use the method which is given in the comparator, the default method. So I can just write comparator dot comparing. If you look at the comparing has how many methods? There are actually 5 methods. Comparing, there is one method, then comparing another method which will take key extractor and comparator, then comparing double, so name itself says that this will compare the double. Comparing int, name itself says that this will compare the int. Comparing long, name itself suggests that it will compare the long. Got it? Now I will go with the first one. So comparing, what I want to compare, I can just write, boss, I want to compare a object with e dot get first name. E dot get here, your sometimes your autofill will not work, So you need to type. Okay, you can see that how simple it is. You can write comparator in one line by using Java 8 feature, by using functional programming. So this comparator, now it will compare your data based on first name. Clear? Same, let's say if you have to compare based on the other data, let's say if you have to compare based on last data, let me write like this, compare by last name. Okay, instead of first name, if you go and if you just change to last name, your comparator, your function is ready, right? Similarly, we will also try to understand the other methods. So if you look at, there is a data, if you look at, there is a data called weight. What is the type of this weight? It is a type of double. Okay, it is a type of double, and you know that with Java 1.8 comparator has one method called comparing double, right? Here I want to compare the double, so I can just go and write comparing double, and here what I have to do, I have to write get weight. Okay, so get weight. Okay, I think I am doing a mistake. Compare by weight. Okay, this was the same reference. So you can see that, that's how you can compare the double type of data. Similarly, I have integer also. So what I can write? Comparing int. Very simple. With Java 8, this comparator becomes very, very simple. Compare by, what is this? This is age, right? So get age. Compare by age. You can see that in within a second you can write one comparator. It's very simple to write, right? So now this is comparing int, right? Similarly, you have comparing long also. It's up to you, how do you want to write that, right? Till here we are clear, and I have covered the methods of all: comparing double, comparing int, comparing long. I don't have long type of data, but still I will write one and I will show you how you can write that. So just you need to change the method. Comparing, you have to use here long. This will compare only long type of data. So age is not a long. Okay, this get age is not a long. Can I just change here to long and let me try if this works. Add cast to E. Okay, that way, this way it will not work. What I have to do is, I have to change this to the, I have to cast this object to the person, and then I think I have to cast to the long. Okay, and then compare by, let's say just write long. Comparing long, what is it is complaining? The type of expressions must be a functional interface. Okay, fine. So this is giving a problem because we don't have long type of data. I was just trying to do some workaround. That's fine. Let me keep this data itself. Whenever you will get a requirement in your project, you can do like this. So when you have a long type of data, and oh wow, this will work. Okay, internally it will compare as a long. Okay, internally it will compare as a long. So let me test that and we'll see that what output we are fetching here. So let me pass this comparing by long and I'm printing the array list. So I think long will accept integer and we should not get any problem. So this was, if you look at guys, this was the age 210 and 90. So how output should come? Output should come first aged 10, then we should get age 90. Yes, it worked. and then we should get age 200. So you can see that sorting is happening, right? Sorting is happening. We are able to see that. So why it worked? Because you know that long can accept the integer kind of data. But if you had here long, so instead of here integer, if you had, let's say, long type of data, then you have a ready-made method. Now there is another method which is pending. We need to understand in the comparing, there is another method which will take two arguments. So if you look at in comparing, there is two method. One is, okay, that's fine. I need to create a reference for that. So the last method of comparing is this method. If you look at the second method, which takes key extractor and then comparator. So why, I mean, where this is useful, we need to understand, like, where this guy will help us, right? So if you look at our program, how we have designed, we have a person object. Inside that we have a employee object. Now I want to do sorting based on my employee object data, right? So based on my employee object data, I want to do a sorting. Then how do I do that? How do I do that? If I will directly go and if I'll directly write like this, let me show you. If I go here and if I'll write e dot get. So can I go and write the method of employee, which is nothing but, let's say, get salary? Can I do that? I want to sort based on salary, right? And can I go here and can I write here employee? It is working, right? It is working. So I can here just a type will be the employee and I can do like this. So the sorting will happen based on the salary, right? Let us run this. So we can write here employee salary comparator. Okay, now let me take this comparator, come to the same comparator and just replace it. See, look at the problem what you are getting, that the problem what you are getting, that when you go to the collection.sort, it will give you some problem. The method sort this in the type collection is not applicable for this argument array list of person comma comparator of employee, right? So what happens is you straight away cannot go to the employee and you cannot sort that, because this employee object present inside the person object, right? Inside the person object. So one thing what you can do that is you can write a for each loop, right? So one thing what you can do that is you can write a one for each loop here, and then this person has this employee, right? So on this comparator you can call for the person object. For every person object you can call that. That is the one way of doing the things, okay? But don't do like that. Whenever you are writing the code, you make sure that it should be uniform. So you should be write in such a way that the collection.sort, it should, and the collection.sort should take care. So how do you do that in that case? Like, whenever you have a nested object, one object within another object, and you need to sort the data of the second object, how do you do that? So that's where your third method we have seen, that will come to the picture. So here change the object is equal to person itself, and if you remember, this comparing has one method is the comparing, the second method was, if you look at here, what it was, not comparing int, there was two method, yeah, this comparing, right? In the comparator class we have key extractor and then we have a key comparator, right? So you can read the Java documentations. They have given very nice Java documentations. You can read that. right? Like how this guy works, you can read that. But how this works is, I will show you. So I can extract the field from my person. So I can write here get employee, right? So basically when I write a get employee, this will give me the object of the employee from the person. So I should write like this, from person you get the employee. This is your extractor. Okay, you got now employee object. Now what you do, once you got the extractor, you need to do salary comparison, right? So when once you have to do salary comparison, on what object you are going to do now? You are going to do on the employee object, because you are extracting this employee from the person object, and then you write O1 comma O2, and then again as it is, whatever logic you have written, you can write like whatever logic you have written earlier, you can write the same logic. O1 dot get salary dot compare to O2 dot get salary. You got it, right? That's how you should write an employee comparator. Whenever you have a two multiple object, one object within other object, you should write like this. From first object, fetch the object. From first object, you fetch first the reference object. On that reference, you write one more functions. That functions will be responsible for your comparison. So you can see that this is your extractor. That is the reason this method has two input. One is the function, right? This is the functions which we have seen that earlier. We have seen that n number of example. So this key extractor is nothing but the functions. This will return you on what object you want to perform comparing. And then this is your comparator. You can write one comparator, right? So that's what I did. I got employee, and then I'm writing that compare to on that salary, right? Clear? Now, same thing I can do in the other way. So what is the other way is, let's say this is the one way of comparing it, right? Same comparing, what I can do here is, I will get the employee, okay, and whatever we have written, comparing int, comparing double, everything will work here also. So here also I can go and I can write comparing int, okay, comparing int. Then in that case, I don't have to write the entire logic. I can just go and write comparing int dot get salary. Isn't this is very simple? This is like, this became very simple. Like, you want to compare the salary of the employee. Let me bring in the one line so that you can see that. See here, this became very, very simple. Here, you are doing that comparator dot comparing int. You do comparison for the salary of the employee. You got it? This is also the way. Either you can write like this, right? Or when you have salary in terms of integer, you can make use of this integer. Or even though you have salary in double or in int, you can go ahead and you can utilize whatever method they have given to us as a part of Java 8. So I can just go here, I can change the reference name, right? You can see that everything is working fine. So whenever we have a different type of data, we can just make use of whatever existing method we have in the comparator as a part of Java 8. So you can see that here I can, so let's say if my salary is in double range, I can write comparing double or comparing long or comparing int, right? So this comparing you are performing against the employee object. You are not performing against the person object, right? But for that, what you have to write, first you have to fetch the reference from the parent object. So basically when you supply person here, which means this E will be mapped to your person object. Okay, E will be mapped to person object. From that person, you are doing that dot get employee. So when you do E dot get employee, what is the return type of get employee? It's an employee object, right? It's an employee object. So once you have an employee object, you can make use of method of the employee. So once you'll have a employee object, you can call the salary and designations of the employee. Clear, right? So we have seen that how we can write the comparator for the second object, like your employee was inside the person, which means your person object has a reference of employee object, and then how do you do that? That's how you can do that, right? Now let's say there is something called designation, right? So how I can write for the designations? For designations also I can write employee salary, employee designations, okay, employee designations comparator. Here I can just write compare dot comparing, and then I can write get employee dot, there is a method called get designations. This is a string, right? A string will work, right? See, I can write in one line. These are all I can write in one line. You can see that this is in one line. I am able to write a this comparator, right? So this is our designations comparator. Let me this also bring to the one line. Compare dot comparing dot employee dot get designation. So this will get this compare will work based on the designations of the employee, right? This is one way of doing that. Or let's say the other way, how you can do that? Let's say you don't want to use comparing, okay? You don't want to use comparing, then what you can do? You can follow the other way also, where you can just write here compare dot comparing, okay, get employee, then this is your extractor, right? Like, you know that comparing has two method, two overloaded method. One is a function comparator and one is just a function. So I can write here function. So this is my extractor. It will fetch the employee object, and then I can write here O1 comma O2. Even I can make use of curly braces here, because I am going to use the body of, I'm just going to make use of the curly braces body, and here I can write. So what I have, O1 O2, right? So I can write here O1 dot get designations dot compare to O2 dot get designations, right? Let me see that why this is complaining. I am doing something wrong here. Compare dot comparing e dot get employee, then okay, this is just I'm writing a curly braces, that is fine, because I wanted to write the body of that. Let me bring in the one line so that we can understand. Then we are writing that compare dot comparing, comparator dot comparing e dot get employee, which is fine, which will give us the object of the employee, okay? And then O comma O2, yes, this is also fine. O1 dot get designations, so this is also fine, because this will give us the designations. And dot compare to O2 dot designation. Okay, one mistake, what I did, it's a my mistake. Whenever you write a curly braces, okay, you need to return this, okay, and your error is gone. So whenever you write curly braces, if you are using a curly braces, you need to return that, okay? You need to return that, because return this comparator always requires a return type, should be integer, right? So we need to return that. Let's say the same thing when you don't write curly braces, because there is only one line, ideally you should not write a curly braces. When you don't write, then this will be resolved at the runtime. Okay. I don't have to write this. Let me see that. Yeah. Get designation. Okay. Put this. This is also not required now. And something I'm missing. O1.get designations compare to comparing. Okay. I was missing the parenthesis. So you can see that the same thing you can write like this also. Compare dot comparing, and here I'm not writing a curly braces, so I don't need to return. Okay, because what happens when you write a comparator, it requires a return type. Without return type, you cannot write that. So if you'll go the comparing method also, click on control, click on comparing. So comparing, basically what happens is internally we are writing a function, first functions, which will give us the employee object, and then we are writing a comparator, right? You can see that, and then internally it will call the comparator, it will do the comparison, right? So now this is also fine. So this is another way we can write the comparator, and you can test. So whatever comparator you are keep on writing, same you can test that, right? By now what we have studied, we have studied mainly four methods, actually five concepts we have understood all together. One is how we can replace the old way of comparator to the new way. The other methods are how we can write comparing double, comparing int, comparing long, as well as there is another overloaded comparing method where it accepts functions and then comparator, right? So basically 5-6 methods we have seen that. In next video I will show you other methods which we have in this comparator class. Thank you guys. Thank you for watching this. Please make sure that whatever functions I have written, you please test it, right? You please test it. I'll share the code with you also. Thank you guys.